defy regulations.
Philip DiBella isn't mincing his words.
And if you support them mandating something like this, that you have your human rights taken away on where you can eat, where you can drink, where you can associate, where you can go, you've got rocks in your head and this country has gone mad.
The entrepreneur says he won't force patrons to prove their vaccine status from December 17, saying it goes against their human rights. Under the restrictions, unvaccinated staff, patrons and business owners would be banned from a raft of venues unless they can prove they're double vaxxed.
It is legally required. A public health directive is a legally binding directive. It can be enforced by law and fines can be issued by the police.
Forget about the vaccine. It's not about vaccine or not vaccine. It's about mandating something that takes away freedoms of people if they don't comply.
The contentious issue has sparked protests which are only likely to intensify. Even some who've had the jab think the new rules are an overreach.
It's blackmailing people to get it. To get vaccinated, I think. I think it's going to divide the community and cause problems.
People are being forced to do something that they don't want to do in certain cases, and isn't that their right to take a chance? You know, it's only the unvaccinated who are going to suffer the consequences.
Civil libertarians say the state government is treading a dangerous line where any existing social division over the issue will be magnified.
It's going to result in the unvaccinated people becoming stigmatised and treated as some second-class citizen, not only in a sense of being excluded from venues, but they're going to be identified and people are going to know who they are.
Billionaire businessman Clive Palmer will launch his own legal fight against the regulation, a battle experts say he's unlikely to be alone in.
Rather than settle these things in the courts, what I think the government needs to do is have a rethink about how these types of laws can be and ought to be applied to ordinary citizens, who, of course, they represent.
Penalties for not complying with the rules are likely to be severe. The government's already indicated fines on the spot of around $1,400 or up to $14,000 if it gets to court.
As for the restrictions set to apply to people who present at hospital, the Premier gave this clarity for those who haven't had the jab.
So our hospitals don't discriminate if you are vaccinated or unvaccinated. But if you are unvaccinated, you are more than likely to end up in ICU.
The chasm between those who have and have not been jabbed is growing, with discontent about what's to come.
The standard you walk past is the standard you accept. And is this something that you're prepared to accept? Because God knows what's coming if you are.